Okay guys, so this is the video. We are talking just about the compressor. So if you came here to see laser cutting, you're not seeing it in this video. This is only about the compressor that we are using in conjunction with our 500 watt fiber laser. This is a Quincy QT5. It's a 5 horsepower compressor. We got ours in single phase because for some reason that's what we have in these buildings. I don't know why they cheaped on it, but whatever, single phase unit. So some of the additional add-ons that we did that we do feel is necessary, we have a intercooler behind. You probably can't quite see it. It's a radiator unit that pre-cools the air right after compression. This is the 80-gallon tank model. I would not recommend going any smaller. Just, you know, you want to have a nice big tank. Other things we added on. So, oh, this is the most important thing is... right back here, it's called the LVD Dual Control. And what it is, there's a little valve back here. You turn it about a quarter of a turn. And what it does is when the compressor is rising to its shutoff pressure, instead of shutting off, it pulls the valves open. So the compressor will just make a whooshing sound, but the motor never shuts off. Now that's important for us for a few reasons. One, it lets us operate at a higher continuous pressure. Normally the switch will turn on about 145 PSI and shut off at 170, 175. This way we can actually hold it right at about 165 to 170. It'll just sit there hovering in that range. So as soon as it hits 165, you can hear the compressor re-engage and build the pressure up for a few seconds and it shuts right back off. So it's very important for laser cutting because we need as much pressure as we can get, especially when you get into thicker materials like 16 gauge. If you saw our other video, you need about 160 PSI to do that. So that's an absolutely critical function to have is the dual control. Going on, other things we added. So we have the tank drain, the electronic one. Now we hooked ours up with half inch hose. I would not recommend that. Get a smaller hose and I'm going to show you why. Imagine this going off randomly while you're just working in a quiet shop unloading the machine. That happens every 45 minutes if this is left plugged in. So I only use this intermittently. I'm going to put a smaller hose on it. I just haven't yet. Let's see. We added the low oil switch just because, you know, if these things run empty, they'll break. And, well, that's expensive, so we just added that. That covers the compressor. So I'm going to go over every part that we had to purchase and who we purchased it from. Kind of just so you can get all the parts ordered at one time. That way, you know, you're not ordering parts after the compressor comes in. So the first thing, this valve is included. It goes to a half inch male coupler and it goes to our QMF50 air filter. Then we use a male hose. Now we used a one with a swivel. That's not necessary if you're using the cooling unit that we're about to go up to because the cooling unit has gasket type fittings, so you don't have to spin the hose to tighten it. You can just push the hose against it and then you spin a separate nut. So goes to hose. We had to use a female fitting. Now if you can get a hose with a female with female ends, you can reduce a coupling. And that goes to this unit, which is the QPNC-25 compressed air dryer. This is a refrigerated unit. I would recommend getting the one directly from Quincy. It's, weirdly enough, cheaper buying it through them instead of trying to get it through another dealer. Don't get a Harbor Freight one. They're only rated for like 135 PSI. This unit's not very expensive. Let's see here. It's $927 as of September 2019. It's made in Italy. It's a good unit. It has auto drain in it, so this uses a refrigeration unit to separate the humidity from the air. You need really dry air so you don't get any liquid into your lenses on your laser. And it's good for a lot of other things too. We go on to another flex hose. Again, this doesn't need to have a swivel. Ours did. It male fittings into a regulator. Make sure on your regulator that it not only can handle the input pressure, but also output pressure. Our first one we purchased, it could take 225 PSI in, but it maxed out at 140, and that was kind of a useless regulator. Then we have a male coupling, Street T. I'm going to try to have an Amazon list for these parts. That way you can just get them all. I don't get paid for it, so feel free to shop around anywhere you can. To a couple of street elbows, so I have a nozzle for filling up tires or whatever, because you know it's nice to have compressed air at the shop. Then we'll go to a QCF 50 filter. This is a particulate filter. It also separates some water. Of course, there really isn't any in the line at this point. Another male coupling and a... Which one is this? It's a CX-NT00060 compressed air filter. Another coupling and then a QAF 50. This is a fine particulate and I believe oil separator. Actually, I think it's just carbon. It separates basically any oil fumes that may be remaining from the air compressor. Then we go to our T and our regulator, or not a regulator, gauge that we use for setting the pressure on the machine. Now, one thing you might be saying, hey, you have your regulator on the wrong side of this apparatus. I'm aware it's not as good, but I didn't want any oils from this cheap regulator ending up in my laser, so we put it before the filters. That way the filters will pick up any oils and fumes and debris from the cheap manufacturer that made this part. Then we go to a reducing bushing and a 10 millimeter fitting that goes to, this is nylon hose. There's another material. What is it, the black stuff we have?
LDPE.
LDPE, don't use that hose. It can't take the pressure, but the nylon 10 millimeter, I think, check it. It's usually rated for about 250 PSI, so it can handle the pressure that this compressor can output. The last kind of part on this is we have a QCS 100. This is a water oil separator. You have to pre-charge it with water, and then the discharge water goes into that. And the oil and water separate by magic, I think. I'm not actually sure how this thing works. But then it just, its outlet drain is here, and we just have it in a popcorn bucket because we don't make that much water. So we have both of our refrigerated unit and our tank drain both go into it and separate the oils from the waters. One thing I think I forgot to mention also, something I wish I had is a start-stop button on the compressor itself. I ended up kind of using the wiring. There's a circuit that goes through the oil switch and the pressure switch that shuts the unit off, and basically all I did is I took that apart and spliced into it a emergency stop switch, so when this is pushed, it's the same as if the oil sensor was triggered or the pressure switch was triggered. One or the other, it's doing the same thing and shutting the compressor down. But it would be nicer to have had a switch because that was a kind of a pain in the butt to wire that in. Now, if you want to use this exact same setup, the parts that all came from Quincy, the compressor, filter, or water separator and filters all came directly from Quincy. The quote number is BMA-676043. This is a blank quote I had prepared. It does not have my name associated to it, so you can give your Quincy representative this part number and they should be able to look it up and pull every part, so that way you don't have to spend as much time researching each part. So to start the compressor up, what we're going to do, we're going to have everything plugged in. We're going to turn our dryer on first, give that just a little bit to cool down. It goes to 38 Fahrenheit. Of course, if you're in a different country, it'll probably be in Celsius. It's very near freezing, but just above it. Once that warms up a little bit, we'll go ahead and turn the compressor on. Okay, so it's still above its set pressure. So we're going to open up this valve here.
Let's go ahead and hit the stop.
right, so now that it's building up, we're gonna lean underneath and it's on the right hand side. We're gonna just turn this, from our perspective, it's clockwise, but if we're on the back of the machine, it'd be counterclockwise. And we're gonna go about a quarter turn. Now that sets the, that adjusts the pressure. The more you turn it, the lower the set pressure will be. So you just wanna, you want it as close to the top. If you go too high, the compressor will switch back and forth real fast. You gotta adjust it a little bit. And the reason why you're going to need that expensive water filter, of course, is so you don't get any oils or any contamination in any of your drainage recharge ditches, because that'd be very bad for the environment. So it's really important to spend a couple hundred dollars to make sure you don't let any, even so much as a finite amount of oil, to get into the ground.
Our neighbors.